Hello students, we were learning the chapter 3, the story of an invitation. We have discussed half of the lesson. Today I will continue with the next paragraph of the lesson. I hope you remember the story. So let me read the chapter and I will explain it for you. I don't think you ought to do that, Grace, she said thoughtfully. You are not strong and you need a good rest. It will be awfully trying to work at Kirkman's summer. So, you remember that Grace was planning to go and work in a library, arranging the books, and Bertha told that it is your health will not be enough to do that and you should not go for that. So you should go for some other work. There is nothing else for me to do, said Grace, trying to speak cheerfully. So Grace was happy to go and help in the library, and she was very cheerfully told that there is nothing else to do. You know that Grace is all alone at home, she has nobody, and where else she will go? So that was she was telling that I will go and help her. The clerkman's place. You know, I am a poor as the proverbial church mouse. What's the meaning of proverbial church mouse? It is written here of the nature of the proverb. It's a poor mouse, proverbial church mouse. Bertha, as the simple truth is that I can afford to pay my board all summer and get my winter outfit unless I do something to earn. So if I don't go to earn the money, how can I pay the board fees and buy the winter clothes? So you know that she has nobody, and where from she will get the money? That's what she wanted to go and work in the library and get the money. Okay, I shall be too busy to be lonesome, and I shall expect long newsy letter from you. Tell me all your fun. Passing your vacation on to me at second hand, you see. So Grace was telling that I will be all alone if I sit in the boarding school. It is better that I must go and work and outside in the library. So, and I will be getting all the news of your vacation, Bertha. So you please write to me now and then, so I will come to know what you are doing there. Well, I must set to work at all these algebra problems. I tried them before dark, but I couldn't solve them. My headache, and I felt so stupid. How glad I shall be when exams are over. So while they were talking with each other, who were talking with each other? Bertha and Mary, they were talking with each other. The Grace told that, no, and now I don't want to waste my time. I have to do solve some problem, that is algebra problems in maths. And I tried so many times. I am very weak in maths. So I will, once again, I will try, right? I was solving some solutions. I got headache. And now I am going to do that. So I will be very happy that I shall be completing my exams. I will be waiting to finish my exams, get over. I suppose I must revise senior English this evening, said Bertha absently. So Bertha also told that I also want to do some English, to learn some books and learn some English words and also I am also going. I don't need to waste our time, so we will go and study. But she made no move to do so. She was studying her friend's face. How very pale and thin Grace looked. So who was studying the friend's face? Bertha was studying the friend's face. Why she was doing that? So when she was looking at Grace, her face looked so pale and weak. She looked very, very thin and weak. So she was looking at her friend's face. Surely much paler and thinner than when she had come to the academy. And she had not by any means been plum and rosy then. So when Bertha was looking at Grace's face, and the Grace looked very thin and pale. Okay, and she was feeling very weak also. So she was looking the early times when she came to the hostel, when she came to the boarding school, she was looking much better. But now she looked very pale and weak. So she was thinking how she will go the 2 months in a clerkman's place and work. She felt sorry for her friend. I believe she could not stand 2 months at clerkman's, thought Bertha. If I were not going to Anne's Meg, I would ask her to go home with me. So she was thinking that how could she go and work 2 months because of her this weak, her health is very weak, and if I could ask Aunt Meg to take her also, let us see what will happen. Otherwise I could take her to my own home. Or even if I ask Aunt Meg had a room for another guest, I had just write to her about all Grace and ask if I could bring her with me. Aunt Meg would understand, she always understands, but she hasn't, so it can't be. So she has a highly thought about the Aunt Meg. Aunt Meg is very understanding. And I will ask her, who is thinking about this? Bertha is thinking that I will ask Aunt Meg to accommodate Grace also with her. So I will write a letter to her asking her to call Grace also for the vacation. Just then a thought darted into Bertha's brain. What nonsense, she said aloud. So suddenly and forcibly, what Grace fairly jumped, what it is. So while he was thinking all this, thought comes to her mind, what will happen? So how can I leave Grace and go here? And so while these thoughts were coming to her mind, she said, what a nonsense. So the voice came aloud and Grace asked Bertha, what is happening, Bertha? What's the problem? What you are talking about? So, oh, nothing much, said Bertha, getting up briskly. What is the meaning of briskly? The meaning of briskly is quickly, fast. She got up very fast. See, I am going to get into the work. I have wasted enough time. Who told this? I have wasted enough time. So Bertha told Grace that I have wasted enough time in talking and thinking things. So now I am going to do my homework and going to study. Okay, so dear students, that's all today. We will go through the chapter once again, and also I have written the word meanings here. You will be revising the word meaning and learning it also. So you will be also learning for the periodical test. Okay, revising the question answers and word meanings and studying, sitting and studying at home. Thank you so much for listening.